Jazzers Summer League, Utah Jazz, and with me, I have Chris Morris from the 97-98 NBA Finals team with the Jazz. I know it's got to be great to be back into the house, in the house that Larry built.
Hey, man, it's fun right now. I'm enjoying myself watching this team here play and analyzing what coaches do now. And maybe sometime tomorrow I'll put my little input in on what somebody need to do and get a little bit better.
Okay, so you'll put on your coach's hat tomorrow, but I do want to pick your brain a little bit about one thing, positionless, the way the NBA has become more positionless today.
It has. It's changed a lot. You know, from where it used to be power game, inside, outside, now it's all about being fast. But the problem is now, there are not a lot of great shooters out there to for this style of basketball, you know. But right now, hopefully the Jazz can find some more nucleuses to help the starting five to come off the bench and help win some more games and get into the finals.
Well, take me back to those finals, that experience for you, and just, we want to relive it like it was just yesterday.
Every time I come back here, it's always about everybody asking the same thing. You know, I relive it all the time. You know, you can't never forget that. Those are a lifetime of a person want to play into your finals. But I knew in my heart, like I told everyone else, man, I said, we won that game, that pinnacle game right there. We'd have been in game seven. We'd have won seven.
Well, we know Coach Sloan is here tonight. Have you had a chance to speak with him?
Not yet. I saw Coach Johnson, I saw Mark Eaton. But right now, I'm waiting to see him and give him a hug because, you know, it's been a while since we last saw each other.
How would you describe Coach Sloan?
Hard nose, he's a fighter, you know. I think once I got here, you know, you have to feed off what a coach likes to do and want a team to do. Be a grinder. So basically, we was a grinding team that knew how to win.
Yeah, I know I spoke to you in Houston in the playoffs for the Jazz. You got to see Donovan Mitchell firsthand in this new-look Jazz team that still has that grind mentality. What are your thoughts on the future of the franchise?
It's coming. It's coming like an explosion, you know. Everyone got a taste of it. I got a taste of it when I was watching them play against the Rockets. And I wish I could be on the sideline and just tell him how to handle the pressure a little bit more to where he can surpass that. And now that he's got his taste of playoff, it's a time for him to take it to the next level now.
All right. Well, I appreciate you joining us. And we'll put the coach's hat on after you get a little more action and you can see Grayson as well a little bit more.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to talk to him, too. I'm going to give a little bit of knowledge of what he needs to do because it's a different game that he's coming into from college to the NBA. Because you already know, once you get somewhere in the midseason, your season should be over for college for basketball, even in the playoffs in college. So right now, we don't want him to learn how to stay in condition and then don't hit that brick wall.
So in addition to conditioning, first piece of advice for the young guy.
Hey, be ready to start shooting that ball. Be ready to start shooting. You still got the aggressive mentality, but that's good. But now in the NBA, you got to learn how to finish at the basket because now it's a more athletic game.
Wise words from Chris Morris.